Welcome back at the course Accounting for Creative. Today we're going to talk about income tax. In the Netherlands, we have three boxes, as we call it, where we divide the income tax that you need to pay. The first one, box number one, is all the income you earn with work, also as a freelancer. So this is kind of the box that we are interested in today. But just to be complete, box number two is for if you have a big company like a BV or an NV, and you have to and you receive dividends for your shares in this company, then you pay taxes in box two. And finally, if you have a lot of possessions like savings on the bank or shares or property that you can rent out or land, then you pay tax over the income you receive from this property in box number three. But as said, we will do mainly now the income tax you have to pay in box one from your work and your freelance business. Make sure that you do your declaration of your income tax every year before May 1, because that's the deadline for this declaration. So just let's look at some screenshot from the declaration form. Of course, it's in Dutch again, but I will translate it and explain it to you what you have to do here. And it gives you also an idea what kind of figures you have to keep during your bookkeeping activities to make sure that you can fill in this form at the end of the year. So this first sheet tells you to ask you, did you have a company? And meaning not a BV or an NV, so a small company like a freelance company, an eenmanszaak, as we call it in Dutch. When you say yes, then you will be asked if you really are an entrepreneur through the eyes of the tax authorities, meaning you have to match a few criteria, and they are mentioned in the website, whether you have enough customers, if you have enough authority to do your job on your own way, if you make enough hours for your job, etc., etc. If you match these criteria enough, then you're considered to be an entrepreneur. And it has advantages because you get tax reduction for that. Then the next page, you will have to fill in your profit and loss account. So all the revenues that you had, you fill in on the top of this form. And all the costs that you have, will you fill in the end of this form. And the program will calculate whether you had a profit or a loss and how much it will be. So these are the information that you have to have at hand when you fill in this form. So that's why you need to keep your bookkeeping up to date. Then at the end, you will have to add some depreciations that we talked about. So your investments becoming less in value. Also this you have to mention on this in this form. So that's why you have to make sure that in your bookkeeping, it's a separate account so you can easily get this number, this amount, to fill in onto this form. Well, let's see what more do we have. At the end of the profit and loss account, you the program will calculate how much profit you had, so you don't have to do that yourself. Then you're going to your balance sheet. This is also something that you have to fill in this income tax declaration. And you see here all the main entrants that you also have seen on the balance sheet. If we go to into detail, you will have to make your fixed assets, like your investments, your camera, your car maybe, or other things that will last more than 1 year. You will have to fill in the amount of this and also the claims that you have to customers or other debtors that owe you money. And finally, how much money you have on your bank and in your cash register. This is the asset side. Then we go to the liability side of the balance sheet. Your equity is being asked here on the top of this form. Some other things that you will never use. Of course, it's much more wider than you need for as a freelancer. So a lot of these fields will remain empty, but that's okay. It makes it only easier. And you have to fill in the debts that you have to your suppliers or maybe other people that you loan money from. The most important thing is that all these numbers are kind of correct and that they match with the profit and loss and with the previous year, that if you have already done this before. So it's really like a big control form that checks everything with numbers that should be matched, that should be in the same area. Good, and I told you before, private deposits and private withdrawals are asked separately on this income tax declaration, and you see them here. You have to tell them how much money you got out of your business and how much money you put into your business. And this can be money or like goods and the value of these goods you have to mention here. These are separately asked, so you better separately keep them in your bookkeeping too. That makes it easier in the end of the year. Good, so this is a little bit how your income tax form looks like, and you can have an idea what you need to do at the end of the year. Maybe you need some help still with a bookkeeper or something, but at least you know what you're talking about and what kind of work you have to do during the year to make sure you have the right numbers at the time of your declaration. So we're almost at the end of this course. We're just going to talk a little bit about bookkeeping programs, and we do that in the next video. See you there.